Voice of Rivers Expedition is a really unique expedition that focuses on the study of a river from source to sea. We purposefully make up an expedition team made up of students from all different disciplines on our campus and faculty as well. And each participant actually studies the river and looks at the river through their unique lens of their discipline. And then they share that with each other and share it with people that we meet. Hi, I'm Clyde Carter, Associate Professor of Wilderness Leadership and Experiential Education at Brevard College, and I was the Voice of the Rivers 2012 Expedition Trip Leader.
Part of environmental crime is watching people do things that are not good for the environment. So it could be something big picture, corporations dumping waste into the ocean or into the river as you're driving past, or just the amount of litter and trash that people throw into the waterways. And one of the exercises students did during the trip was a trash pickup on a private island that the people were kind enough to let them stay on. And it didn't take long to fill up bags of trash. And it's kind of an eye-opener to think, wow, all of this would just be here. Nobody caring about it if we didn't pick it up. So that was kind of a nice thing to do. My name is Amy Scheidegger. I'm a professor in the Criminal Justice Department, and the course I taught for Voice of the Rivers was environmental crime.
Hi, my name is Christina Furt.
Hey, my name is Jeremy Blake.
Hi, my name is Addison Dent.
My name is Anthony Worley.
I'm Elena Reynolds.
Hey, my name is Emily Boykin.
I'm Karen Strickland.
My name is Leah Eggett.
My name is Rachel Anthony.
Ryan Gwill.
I'm Spencer Williamson.
Hi, I'm Christina Nelson.
Hey, I'm Ben Seidman.
And we are the 2012 VOR interns.
And you are watching the 2012 VOR documentary.
All the ducks are swimming in the water. All the ducks are swimming in the water. Falderalderalder, falderalderalder. All the ducks are swimming in the water. Falderalderalder, falderalderalder.
Camp and set up our first campsite. We all loaded back up into the vans and went to a working grist mill that was around Reedsville, which is where we were putting in for the Haw River. And we got to go on a tour of that. There was a nice lady working there that kind of told us how the mill worked, and she had a cool little cat we got to play with. And then we also got to walk around their gift shop, and we purchased some things for them to make along the way on the trip that would kind of remind us of where we'd started. Bushwhacked through the woods and found what looked like a huge puddle in the ground, but it was actually the source of the Haw. It was really cool to see it and get that mental image, and so you could carry it through the rest of the trip and be like, wow, I saw the source of this river, and now it's like this huge class 3 rapid that I'm going down in a canoe, and like it was, you know, finger deep at the beginning.
Leader of the day, what happened this morning?
Oh, leader of the day, I forgot about that. I walked out of my tent to tell everyone how fun it was sleeping on water, yeah. And Dr. Scheidegger was on the ground, and I was like, oh, she fell, that's so funny, good morning, hey, you fell. And then she had some major pain, and she dislocated her left shoulder when she hit the ground. I'm not Woofer or anything like that, so I just was trying to be nice. And now she's making her way to the hospital.
Day two!
A little more rain than we wanted to, but it's okay. We got to get out in the lake and practice some strokes, learned a lot, got to mesh with everyone, see what our partners were like. Later in the day, we went to the state park, Hall State Park, talked to a ranger, and they told us some information and history about the place, and we took a walk and checked it out.
Bottom.
Yeah. Here we got some honeysuckle, and I'm gonna eat it. You got pinch the bottom here, and then this would come through. Here we go. Ready? Wait for it. Oh yeah, look at that right there. Uh huh. And now.
Your face is so close to that.
Oh yeah, it's like sucking honey. Mm, so good. Okay, let's go.
This morning, we went to the where we're gonna put in, and we looked to see how the water levels were and things. And Clyde made the executive decision that it really wasn't safe for us to go out on the river, mainly because of like tree strainers and things of that nature, and the skill level that we have since we have some really new paddlers and things. So it wouldn't be safe to paddle. So instead, we went out on Lake Reidsville again and paddled around and learned some different strokes, and that right now we're doing a service project, picking up trash for them, but so we're gonna really start our journey down the river tomorrow, hopefully, if it doesn't rain. We're really excited about it, kind of anxious to get on the river and actually paddle and get towards the coast. So
hey, good looking, what you got cooking?
How's about cooking something up for me? I'm cutting up some onions and some garlic for, we're making some Thai noodles with like peanut sauce and stuff. And yeah, we just put some seasoning on there. I'm so happy to be cooking right now.
Me too.
And guess what? Hey, guess what?
Don't sit.
Yay, happy birthday, Clyde! Woo!
Hey.
Hey.
What are you guys doing?
We're making a birthday cake.
Gluten-free cake
for Karen's birthday?
Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday to you!
Happy birthday to you! Yeah! So it's day four and we're going paddling! Yeah! So the river was finally low enough, so we're gonna put in right below one of the dams, and then we're gonna have a quick portage over the Altamaha Dam, paddle our way down to Shallow Ford, and we'll see how it goes. Hang out, camp, and then go paddling again tomorrow.
This is Shallow Ford Natural Area, the park that we will be staying at after our canoe trip today. Pretty cool. Guys offered us a little bit of t-shirt.
River Trail stickers.
Yeah.
That's what we want.
I love it. Yeah.
Thank you, sir. We'll see you soon.
See you guys.
I don't need no
for dinner tonight, cooks?
Is this the interview?
The interview.
The interview? Here, come on over here. Come on over here. Check us out. We're making some vegetables! And vegetables!
And onions! That is the best part of this meal, no doubt. Are you salivating?
Bit about the connection of the river and water-powered mills, okay? Should go into that with you, or is this cool stuff for you?
That's perfect.
Okay, good. Okay. If I go off script or off course, somebody just throw a rotten tomato at me, you know? They created a dam to create a mill pond or mill lake, okay? That was a way of storing their energy up, okay? So that they had some control over their energy. This was the last water power mill built by the Holt family. The Holts were like the Rockefellers of Alamance County. They owned like 7 or 8 mills. It was 2 or 3 generations. They produced Alamance plaids up here in Glencoe. If you walk past that dam out there, boy, the cacophony of sound, the volume of sound is just so dramatic, you know. And that's one of the things in connecting with nature, it's not always what you hear, sometimes it's what you don't hear. You don't hear the sound of civilization, which I really envy you guys, because for 2 weeks you're going to be on this river. I mean, man, how cool can that be?
Here, that's a one story.
Okay, you see how that's different than the two story house? It's much smaller.
Definitely a status symbol, probably.
Pardon me?
Probably your status symbol from being in the mill, what level you're in.
There was part of that in how big your family was, okay, and how many people. At one point in time when this mill was hopping, there were close to 450, 500 employees, and about 50 of them, about 50% of those people actually lived in the mill village here. You guys, I'm passing a torch on to you guys. So the solution to pollution starts right here with this group. Whether it's the Hall River, what's your river address up in Brevard?
It's Brevard.
Okay. And when you go home from college, you know, think about your river address and think about the impact that every single person in this group can make an impact for a cleaner environment, a litter-free environment, healthy water supply. Just take that with you on your journey down the river and your journey down through life. Thank you again.
Thanks, Howard.
Yeah, that's great. Ryan here. Leader for the day. Went through 2 dams earlier this morning. Actually ran off one of them. It was pretty fun. Then we're here at Glencoe Park talking to Howard. Good guy. He taught us a lot about the mills and stuff down the river and pollution that companies used to make, that the laws now have helped out with that. And now we're headed to the island.
Spirit Island.
Spirit Island. We're headed to Spirit Island. We got 2 more dams to go and a lot of mileage. So we got a long afternoon ahead of us. Ready to go.
To guess what it was, Spirit Island, and Clyde got permission from this guy to let us camp there. We get there and not really sure what to expect, but it was like the old dam. So there's this old building. It's like he put like bottles sticking out of it, I guess, to be artsy or something. And we had to portage our canoes, and there's actually these 2x4s that he made to portage canoes. There's little signs to go and stuff, and we had to portage our canoes over and whatnot. And then we got to our campsite, and all it is like this platform of wood that he made with like a sectioned off piece, and all around it's just like vegetation. It's like you're in the jungle or something, and there's stinging nettles there that some people got stung by, and and we camped out there, and like I said, it was a pretty long day. I remember everyone's pretty tired, and but I was definitely pumped up. It was my 21st birthday.
What's for dinner?
We are cooking pasta to make spaghetti or pasta noodles, whatever you want to call it.
Pasta noodles. These stoves are being such a pain right now, and overflaming and stuff, and everything's going crazy, and they're finding ticks on us and everything, but we're going to have awesome pasta, so it's going to be great. And bread, check this out. And it's your birthday this time.
Yeah, get out of our kitchen.
I had an idea to do something else for my birthday. You know, I was like, that's my 21st birthday, can't do those regular things, I'll definitely try something else. I hinted to Ben, our videographer, and I was just like, I think I can do something, like get your camera ready.
I'm just gonna check for ticks, you know, in the middle of dinner while everyone's reading, or not reading, while everyone's eating,
like no big deal, I'm just gonna check for ticks. It's like, okay, and Ben's all like looking around, all sketchy, like pulling out his camera. I pop out naked with no clothes on and a hat on. And I ran across the platform and screamed woohoo, or it's my 21st birthday or something. And as I'm doing it, everyone's just kind of still eating, cracking up, but like people just like keep eating. It's just like naked kid just ran through camp, but whatever.
There's naked boy.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Spencer.
Elena Reynolds here. This is day 6, and we woke up at 6 a.m. this morning, and we got our boats on the water at 7, and we were actually on time today, so I'm really proud of our group. We just paddled 4 miles, and it's right now 9:20. We are in Saxapaha, North Carolina. We just had a nice conversation with Joe Jacobs, who helped us out a lot with our portage. Right now we're cooking breakfast, and then we're gonna head down the river for another, how many miles? Like
16, 17.
So yeah, we got a long day ahead of us.
Pulled into Saxapaha, spent the night, and in the morning, Joe Jacobs helped us with our shuttle of our boats to around the dam to put in. And we got talking to him. He's an awesome guy. He goes out to Alaska and does some stuff, but he owns a little river guide service there. So we're talking to Joe Jacobs, and that took up a bunch of time, and before we knew it, we were like, we gotta get going. And then we noticed that none of us has really eaten anything. It's early in the morning, we haven't had breakfast or anything like that. And then all of a sudden Clyde's like, woohoo, come with me. So we go walking down the street, we're like crossing around the road, we're kinda like looking around, we're like, what's going on? And he's like, well, we're gonna go find somewhere to eat breakfast. We're like, oh, okay. And we found this little place, and we were treated to breakfast, which was a great surprise.
Saxapaha blend coffee and a stout.
We got distracted at the puppet place. Joe Jacobs was like, hey, you should check out the upstairs of my guide service. We're like, oh, okay. So we go up there, and there's like this whole puppet theater, and they're like life-size puppets, and Addison's got like the heads on, like dancing with his life jacket on and stuff, and people are all like, oh my god, and like, they were like really good, like detailed puppets, a lot of cool paintings everywhere, so we got distracted by that, and then we went to go get some breakfast, and I think I had like a bacon, egg, and cheese on a biscuit with like a coffee and orange juice. It was really good.
So after our big portage, we were kind of zigzagging through a rock garden. It was kind of hard, dry rocks, the river was a little low. And we got piled up, and suddenly there was a class 3 drop, like 4 feet, a little over. And it was just a straight down, and Jeremy and I were like, we got locked up behind it because 2 people got stopped up below it, and we're just like, oh my god! And then they said, okay, you're good. And we're just like, just like right below it. We just did not catch it, and there was 2 rocks, and it totally flipped our boat. And we were just like, and we had to bail it for like 5 minutes. It took forever. She's like, oh my god, stop.
And then we paddled to our campsite, and I'm soaking wet, and it's been a lovely 22-mile day. Day six!
Day seven, I'm leader of the day. We were supposed to be on the water 2 hours ago, but we had some driving shuttle issues, people getting lost and such. We're really excited, waiting for two more paddles to come so everybody can paddle, because we left our paddles in the other van, and we're gonna get on some class three rapids. Woo! Excited, everyone's thrilled about it, so it'll be a good day.
He right here followed the gluteus maximus line, you see?
It's like old times, they hear me coming through your speakers. You see me mashing up your airways. I know you can't get enough of my sound. It's like old times, they hear me coming through your speakers. You see me blocking up your airways. I know you can't get enough of my sound. There's nothing to hurt, so stop the fight, I'm gonna get it. Daughters running from me, baby, you're gonna regret it. I can understand why you can't free yourself.
Alright, we made it to Jordan Lake. We're eating lunch at 4:20, and Spencer and Addison are doing handstands. Backstreet Boys. We're finished with the canoes for this trip, and we're about to switch over to sea kayaks when the vans get here to paddle another 4 miles to our campsite. Everyone's really excited!
Woohoo!
Stopped and we switched over to sea kayaks and we paddled for what was supposed to be like 2 miles, but it was really more like 5 or 6. And we got to the campsite. We were supposed to have, like, make all of our food and everything. And my parents ended up buying lots of barbecue and driving out and surprising us all. So that was really, really awesome.
Best food in the world, and we got to eat it that night, and it was just. Oh, it was like a buffet. Everybody had like 4 helpings. We were so tired from the long stretch across the lake, and it was just a great meal. All
right, I'm Spencer. I'm the leader of the day today, and it's day 8 here in Voice of the Rivers. We're here at beautiful Lake Jordan, and we are getting sea kayaks today, and we are traveling about 15 to 20 miles. I think it might be a little longer. We're not sure. We got one huge dam portage, like 50 feet up on one side, 100 feet up on the other side. So, gotta deal with that, and continuing on down to the river to get to the ocean at some point. It's gonna be a good day.
So, our favorite portage, affectionately known as the Dam Dam. Next morning we got up, loaded up, and paddled up to this dam, which looked pretty big from far away, and then as we inched in closer, it was like monster dam, 100 feet up, 100 feet down, and we all have loaded boats. We're getting pushed into the banks with the wind, and it's like a pretty rowdy time. We kind of find this little cutout in the brush and start to pull boats up, and then use sheer brute manpower to haul these loaded boats up to the top of this dam, and then back down the other side.
When we got down to the other side, I believe we had some lunch, and everyone was just kind of definitely feeling it, so we just all kind of got together and did pretty much like a hands in and a woohoo, and everyone's doing better. And then we had to pull the boats down in the water for about 30 feet or so, there was all these like small little boulders that were just piled on there to create like a retaining wall before the dam. And walking on this was sketchy. Pulling boats down, it was even sketchier. And we got in like two lines and we all kind of shuttled the boats down. And it was hard and definitely had to use a lot of teamwork, a lot of communication to get through it. And we did. We did awesome.
We're leaving the Hall River. Woo! Welcome to the Cape Fear. 200 miles to the ocean.
Then had another dam portage and we had to pull boats up this hill and there was like two person on a rope pulling up and then one person shoveling over, another went down the other side, so we had one person on a rope that side went right down. We had to do all the boats, and by that time we got to camp super late. It was dark out and we were just super happy to be there. Made some dinner and went to bed.
So here it is, day 8 at night. We just got to camp. It's about, let's see, 9:43. And we finally traveled from the Hall to the Cape Fear, and we were paddling at the dark tonight trying to find our camp. It took a little longer than expected. We had one surprise rapid, which is always cool, but we made it, and we're getting dinner ready. People signed up camp, and VOR style, Brevard College.
I'm Anthony Worley, leader of the day, day 9, May 21st. Monday. We are 21 minutes behind schedule right now, leaving this morning. It is 6:21 right now. We're supposed to be on the water at 6. We are headed into Lillington, then to a senator's house, and then to a farmer's house for the evening. Should be an eventful day. We got some pretty intense rapids for the sea kayaks. I'm excited.
We maneuvered our agenda that we're going to go visit old Senator Morgan. And he lived right there on the Cape Fear River. And we pulled up to his house in his backyard, got out, and was greeted by him and his wife. Had us inside, and he had a cooler of Coca-Colas and bananas and apples or something like that. We're like, oh my God, soda and fresh fruits and stuff. So it was great. Went to his garage, and he had a Fairlane 500 in there, a beautiful old classic car that they just restored. And then took us into his basement, walk in, and it's like, well, almost walk into the Oval Office. But you walk in there, and there's like typical like old pictures, and like, and we were just all like jaw dropped with the stories that he's telling us and the pictures that we were seeing. Very nice and a great experience to hear his stories, look at those pictures, and to be at his home and get to talk to him.
Touch our stank laundry. Oh my gosh, that was so, I didn't even want to touch it. And here was Nancy just saying, yeah, just, okay, just put it in here. I'm going to go wash it for you. I'll bring it out when it's done. And she had it all folded up. I just, oh my God, it was so overwhelming. I think we're all almost brought to tears.
My name's Anthony Worley. I'm the group leader of the day. We are currently at Willow Pond Farmstead, owned by Rick and Nancy Rogers. They were kind enough to put us up. This is day 9 of our Voice of the Rivers trip. Everything is going real well. I'm super happy to be the leader of the day for today. Very nice break in the stressful, strenuous days that we've had. We got up really early this morning. We got up at 5. I think everybody was a little disgruntled about that, but I think it paid off in the long run. Overall, I think we're really, really happy to be here.
What are you fishing for?
Anything that bites. There's some bluegill, there's some largemouth, and some fairly large catfish.
Well, good luck.
How are you guys enjoying the farm?
Oh my God.
Is it super amazing?
I'd never want to leave, ever.
Never ever?
No.
It's a pretty good place, right?
Yeah, I'm in heaven.
Jeremy?
I'm liking it.
How are you guys enjoying the farm?
Awesome.
This is incredible.
Cows, ducks, goats. Geese.
Poison ivy?
Chicken.
Let's see your poison ivy. Where is it?
I'm working on it right now.
You're working on it?
It's pretty much my whole foot. It's whatever. You want to see the gruesome part?
No, we'll save that. Who are we looking for?
podcast for the Friendly Goat.
All right, VOR 2012, we're on the hunt for Casper the goat. He's a big goat with tusks, he likes banana peels, and we're driving around in our goat hunting mobile. We're gonna go check over here for Casper, hopefully we can find him.
Look over there,
it's an apiary. Look it. So here we have the bees making some honey in their honey house.
In their house.
Come look, come look. These are our VOR bees.
Very fresh. We have an upset mama goose here, and that's her nest.
Oh, yeah. You got some eggs there.
Yeah, and I'm not sure that they haven't hatched. I'm not sure what I think of that. They're obviously being defensive. Here comes Casper.
She's pissed.
Casper.
Casper, come here, boy. What are you guys eating?
Blueberries! They're amazing. You want one?
We are having taco salad bar and banana pudding for dessert, with lemonade and iced tea, and chips and salsa and
be so good.
Thank you.
Yum. Not dehydrated beans.
Yeah.
So we woke up on the morning of day 10, and we were at this gorgeous farm that we had stayed at the night before and had the greatest time and the best hospitality. We load up in our cold, wet boats and head on down the river again. Finally made it to where we thought we were going to be camping mileage-wise. We couldn't find our access point, which was a set of stairs coming down into the water. Spirits were kind of low. It was starting to rain and storm. Emily and I were in the tandem having a pretty good time. Addison was struggling a little bit with some bowel movements that he couldn't relieve himself of. But long story short, we found a little cove and sent a scout up into it, and they found this random set of stairs, and Ben and Christina were there with smiling faces waiting to help heave boats and people up the staircase.
Karen and Emily here.
Boarding in.
Lost in the middle of the river.
Yep. A little MIA.
That's where we're not supposed to be, but we still haven't found our campsite, which was
supposed to be that way.
Supposed to be 22 miles from where we started, and we've paddled more than 24.
25 right now. We're not supposed to go over there.
And it's starting to rain, and we've paddled a lot.
Yep.
And Addison really has to poop. And that is all.
That's all.
Until we find
from us again?
Some stairs.
We're still in the river.
What are you cooking?
I am cooking some stir fry right now. I'm breaking up some fresh broccoli that's been sitting in ice, and that's something we're not used to.
What are you cooking, Leah?
Sauteing up some broccoli and some onions, and then we're waiting for the rice to boil so we can turn it down so it can soak up some of that water.
Today we woke up at the most amazing place. It was a farm, and it was absolutely beautiful, and we sat on the front porch in rocking chairs and had breakfast that was prepared for us, and it was awesome. And then we paddled 25 miles, and like pretty much nonstop, and now we're here at the campground. It's about 8-ish, 8:30, and dinner's being made, and we're just laying out and writing our journals and stuff, so it's been a good day. Yay!
Hey, I'm Jeremy. I'm the leader for the day. Kind of iffy day today. A big thunderstorm forecasted. We're paddling 22 miles to Lock and Dam 3, where we'll be staying. It has facilities, so that's good. So we're just going to try to crank out all the miles we can and hope we beat this storm.
Rachel, what's the meaning of life?
The meaning of life is doing whatever you want to do that'll make you happy.
Okay. Oh, that's so cute. Anthony, what's the meaning of life?
Eat, sleep, paddle.
Yeah.
Well, that's the second sewage dump we've seen into the river today. And like we saw the last one like maybe an hour and a half ago. And it smells disgusting. This is like the rankest thing you've ever seen too. It just bubbles out, just frothing on the go.
We were paddling along and we saw this foam in the water up to the right bank. And we went over there to find out what it was. And there was a pipe that was put in the water, and as the water came out of the pipe, it was sort of foaming up, and it looked kind of like a soap or a sudsy sort of thing. My guess is that it was probably some kind of cleaner, where they clean the water with wastewater or something like that, because there was a sign that said Public Works Commission, so it's from the city that was pumping the water in here. So it's probably, you know, biodegradable or something. They have a... so they can pump it in here, but
you tell them,
it's
Leah.
Still foamy and looks bad, smells kind of fishy, or not really
yeah,
fishy,
it,
smells
it almost smelled like chlorine, like burning nostril
yeah.
stuff.
So I'm pretty sure it was wastewater cleaning, mm-hmm. but this is...
Ryan, what do you think of that?
It was disgusting.
Emily, yeah. What is the meaning of life?
Paddle and eat.
Paddle and eat? What about for you? Probably in sleep. Karen, you're not going to sleep?
I might get the rest of some sleep in there.
Okay.
I'd be into that.
That's cool.
What's the meaning of life, Spencer?
Smiles!
Those dams, we see the noticeable effect. Like, this huge body of water is behind it, and it floods all the area around it. Oh, no. Like the rivers, the great class 3s and 4s underneath the Jordan Lake are gone now because of the river flooding, but it's what happens as a result, like
over time,
man's preventative measures create larger dangers than what would happen naturally. For example, Katrina, the levees in Katrina, I mean, levees are great, they hold back the water, but when it floods, the gradient on the other side, it speeds up the water velocity like almost 100%. So when it actually happens, which it will always happen, there's nothing that's going to really stop it. It just like picked up steam and just wrecked it. That's what I like about rivers. They just keep moving. There's nothing you can do about it. You can redirect it, but then it'll find its way back to where it wants to go anyway. So,
I've heard it once said, you never step your foot in the same river, because that water's already gone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's very true.
So it's day 11, Voice of the Rivers, 2012. It's been a long day, a beautiful day. We've just been paddling. Paddle, 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 paddle all day. Got some sun. Now it's starting to get some storm clouds, some thunder off in the background. But finally at 5:30, there's a sign over there in the trees. It says danger waterfall, 4,000 feet, but that's our dam that we're camping at. So in 4,000 feet, we finally get to camp, make dinner, and eat, sleep, get up and paddle again tomorrow. Living the life. Right, Rachel? Living the life? LTD. Yeah.
All right, we've made it here today just before the storm. 23 miles, and it just started dropping on our heads right when we pulled up, and then it just crashed when we got settled in. It was a good day overall. Saw a lot of cool things.
Yeah. Clyde's trying to get out of the shot. There he is.
Hey, I'm Emily. I'm leader of the day today. It is Thursday, so we have 1 week to go. We spent the night at Lock and Dam 3 last night, and we are paddling to Lock and Dam 2 today. It's 23 miles between the two of them, and it's mostly flat water, so that's what we have in store for us today. The lock master had a talk with us this morning, and it was really interesting hearing about how the locks work and all the change in the river since the Clean Water Act in the 70s. So that was really educational. He also informed us that on this stretch there have been two alligators that have been seen, so we're kind of on our toes and a little jumpy this morning, but hopefully we see them before they see us. It should be a good little paddle today. Ryan is having some problems with his toes. He thinks that they're numb and we don't really know why. So Christina, Ben, and Ryan are taking the day off and going in town to try to get that checked out. Should be a good day.
Record spun, hats, kibasa, the casa, su casa. Now tell me what I'm after. You're not playing a style like this. When I was a youth, I listened to Miles Davis. Lost in space like Neil Armstrong. I used to hum melodies from Louis Armstrong. John. Last night I fell asleep in my home. Had a little dream, don't need a Simone. I laid down and before I came round, and told me, get up like Mr. James Brown.
I like chewy bacon, but on some days I like it crunchy. Clyde, what kind of bacon do you like?
Well, John Buford makes this bacon.
Yeah?
It's got honey on it and cayenne pepper.
Whoa! Elena, what kind of bacon do you like?
Chewy!
What bacon do you like?
Crispy.
Yeah. Crispy? Do you eat bacon? What kind of bacon do you like?
Crispy.
How's it going so far? How far have we gone?
17 miles.
How many more do we have left?
Long way.
How long?
A long way.
Like super long?
We only have six. We have six left. We've gone a long way.
I am the navigator for today. We paddled 23 miles. This is my compass. This is my map. And it was pretty easy going. We had a really fast pace. And the best part of the day was no one got eaten by alligators.
That's pretty good, hey?
Hey.
Yeah! Let's go to camp.
Let's go to camp.
Over there.
Dun da da da.
Dun da da da. Dun da da da. Dun da da da. Dun da da da. Dun da da da. Dun da da da. Dun da da da. All right, let's go.
It's day 13. It's Addison here. We're paddling 24 miles today, 24 long and arduous miles. We've got a lot to look forward to. Probably gonna stop for lunch on a sandbar, stretch our legs, feel the breeze, feel the nature, feel the love.
Day 13!
Wait, what do you use for poison ivy?
Milk of magnesia. It's a laxative. The doctor told me it's the best stuff to use. My leg's been a little bit runny. There's not so much laxative on it, but...
Hi. I'm Addison. I'm leader for today. Day 13. We paddled 24 miles today. And arrived at Oakland Plantation. A farmstead built in the 1700s. And now, the cook group has just set out to cook us some macaroni and cheese. We stopped at a little sandbar today for lunch. Pretty easy day, pretty hard headwind for about 4 miles, 5 miles until we got here. Pulled up on a dock, we have a shower for tonight. I'm going to take a shower. It's a good day. Day 13!
The hospitality that we were shown along the river definitely gave me more hope in humanity. I mean, that sounds kind of ridiculous, but I mean, I would never expect anyone to lend their personal log cabin home, you know, to a bunch of college students that they had never met, that they will never meet, because, you know, we were allowed to stay in somebody's house, and he was a fisherman. I think he was responsible for a certain section of the river, and he wasn't even there to greet us or to see us off or anything, but just said, yeah, come stay in my house. And that was just mind-blowing to me.
It was supposed to be our last, like, 20-mile day, and I was navigating, and I'm paddling along, and I'm trying to follow the map, and something that just doesn't look right. So finally, you know, Clyde and I kind of been talking, and we were like, yeah, 7 more miles! 7 more miles! And it was always just 7 more miles. We get to camp, we're sitting around cooking dinner, Clyde's over in the corner re-measuring the map, and he starts giggling to himself. I was like, all right, Clyde, how many miles did we go? Instead of going 20 miles, we went 32. It was, oh man.
Cannonball! Hello, VOR viewers. I'm Spencer Williamson here. I got a tip for cooling down the river. You're at home underneath your roofs and in a comfy computer chair. We're here in our kayaks with some comfy water. An El Rollo. Woo!
More deciduous, and there was a lot more tulip poplars, hickories, and that sort of thing. And then as you work down, you start seeing the Spanish moss, the cypress, and different more tropical, I guess, but not really still that semi-tropical forest environment along the river was really neat to see it evolve.
Lord, I was going somewhere I had never been before.
On doing a 20-mile day, we got up at around 6:30 or so we could be on the water early, so we could get to camp super early. And then we paddled for about 9.5 miles, so we could portage our very last portage that we're going to do on this trip. It was a nice, easy portage because there was a boat ramp at the end, and we just sort of slipped in, and there was someone in front of me. And then we kept paddling and paddling. It's like it should be just right around the corner. We ended up paddling 32 miles today. We got on the water around 7:30, and we got to our campsite at 7:20. So it was about 10 minutes shy of a 12-hour paddling day. So it was really long and tiresome, but we're excited that we're that much closer to the beach and the ocean, so it's really cool.
It's 4:52 in the morning. We're heading to Wilmington. We want to beat the whichever tide makes it so it works against us, so we're trying to push off at 5. There's still a few people on the dock, but I'm really excited. Some people are really tired, but
it's going to be a good day.
I'm really excited.
I'm really excited.
Spencer's over there in the dark. He's really excited. I'm sure Leah's over there. I think she's sleeping, but she's excited. It's going to be a good day.
Really good day. Woo!
Chiggers on my hand and all over my leg. So now I have 3 bottles of clear fingernail polish that I get to dab on each and every spot that's red and hopefully get rid of them.
I have chiggers too. Not as bad as him.
And Clyde may have some on his feet.
Clyde met this guy CR who offered to come cook us dinner when we got to the marina, which was awesome. Got to the marina. And CR met us there and cooked us this awesome low country boil.
A whole bunch of shrimp and corn, and what else? We have potatoes and chicken.
We just had this huge southern broil, and it was awesome. It was such a great meal, and we all just kind of hung out and cooked together. And then I taught a lesson on the Titan Company. It's a cement company that is proposing building a plant in Wilmington, which is a huge environmental impact to the city of Wilmington and North Carolina in general. A guy named Kemp, he came and he works for Cape Fear River Watch, so he's all about preserving the river and doing a lot of environmental work towards it. And so he helped me kind of teach my lesson about the environmental impacts of Titan and what the people of Wilmington are trying to do to prevent that from happening.
There's 200 keepers all over the country. And
as an environmental activist, like, do you ever think about alternative resources for cement?
There are actually ways to make cement that actually sequester carbon, so you're actually removing CO2 instead of adding CO2. Cement production is a leading source of CO2 emissions, but yeah. There's a way that kind of mimics the way coral reefs produce their calcium carbonate kind of exoskeletons. They actually take carbon out of the water to create these coral reefs, and there's scientists that have actually kind of mimicked that process to make cement, so you're actually taking carbon out. And, you know, we're not arguing against cement.
Yeah.
We're just arguing against producing cement in the coastal plain, which is probably one of the worst areas to do it. There's a list as long as my arm of emissions out of that plant. And what we've said is this county doesn't need any more emissions in our air. We've got bad air quality, and we don't have a place where we can put this plant where it's not having impacts on the people right around it. There's a school, there's 8,000 children that go to school within 5 miles of this plant. We've also said that when you have to dig a hole in the ground that immediately fills up with fresh water, our drinking water, and then you pump that water out into the river where nobody can use it, it's not the right place. When you have to destroy wetlands, and we all know how important wetlands are to all kinds of things. I mean, they're basically where everything gets its start in our area.
Man, I'm really jealous of you guys. Really, really envious, kind of, but really
glad to know that you guys are doing this. How many of you are there?
14
people that I know are going to protect rivers.
Day 16, 9 in the morning, we got to sleep in a little bit compared to the other days. We got up about 8:30, we couldn't sleep any longer. We're at Wilmington Marina. We pulled in yesterday afternoon. We've had some nice meals, having some really nice breakfast right now. There's a storm coming in a couple days, so we're kind of changing up the schedule. Instead of going to Kay Island today, we're going to be going to Curry Island and stay there. So we'll have a little extra mileage with some headwind. But we're going to wait until about 3 o'clock and go out with the tide and head there.
What island are we on, Ryan?
Kay Island.
Yeah? How was the trek here?
Oh, my gosh.
Tell us about it.
It was bad. Wind against us, tide against us. It was bad. It took us, like, I don't know, like, twice what it should have taken us, and we still got double the mileage of what we just did. But Todd's gonna be with us now, so we're gonna try to scoot on out.
Where are we headed to?
Playing in the water right now for a good 15 minutes.
Where are we headed to? Justin.
We're headed to Curry Beach, a little past Carolina Beach, and we're gonna try to stay there, trying to beat the storms coming in so we don't have to paddle through it, because that would be rough. Especially out here in the bay. So
Amber Heck, one of the other students at Brevard, offered for us to stay in her basement. Her family lives on her beach. And we paddled to her house and we cooked out, and Ben and Christina prepared this, like, really amazing cookout for us. And we got to stay inside and have roof and walls, and it was really, really kind of her to do that. And it was awesome to see other people from her life.
Remnants.
Ben, what are you making right now?
I made some burgers, made some hot dogs. This is the grill in which it was all done on. There's a remaining
mushroom that you can't, there you go, for Christina. She's a vegetarian. But it was delicious. The crew is satisfied.
Where's the fried tomato?
Right there.
Fried tomato.
So this one day, I think it may have been that we were blessed a little too much on this trip. We were able to spend the night at this girl named Amber, who goes to school here. We were able to spend the night in her house in an air-conditioned, you know, garage, and we were served wonderful food. And, you know, by that point we thought, you know, what's the point in paddling anymore when we know we need to get to this certain spot? Like, there was a huge storm blowing in, and we all just sort of started losing, I think, the purpose of VR. Was it so much as getting to the place and just being there? It was everything that comes along with it, you know, figuring out along the way, how are we going to make it through this day when so-and-so doesn't feel well, when, you know, so-and-so's back hurting. And those things, I think, are more important than realizing, you know, oh, we can skirt around the original plan as long as we get there in the end. And I think that was our mentality at that point. And after we discussed it with Clyde, I think we almost were embarrassed that we'd even thought of missing something. I mean, how could we doubt, you know, Clyde's guidance, especially in something so wonderful as staying in a conservatory.
We're going to Bald Head Island!
Oh, yeah!
B-O-R!
Hey, it's Karen again. End of our day today. We were fixing dinner and Dr. Scheidegger came and surprised us. She took the ferry over and was here for our last night on Bald Head. The former mayor of Wilmington came and brought two huge golf carts for all of us to fit in and shuttled us to his house here where his family and some of their friends were, and we walked into this phenomenal house that, like, I don't have words to describe because it was so amazing. And then we all sat outside and had a drum circle and played guitar and sang, had a fire and s'mores, and their hospitality was amazing. And it was a really good time. So, fixing to wrap up the night here, and tomorrow we paddle to Southport to have our lunch and then head back to Brevard. Woo woo!
I guess he had a bunch of his family there outside just sitting around this fire pit, and a bunch of people were singing and had, you know, little hand drums out and were just singing random nonsense words, and that really called to me. And so I didn't even know any of the kids that were sitting there and just jumped in and started singing with them. That connection was something that totally sticks in my mind. Music is being one of the universal, you know, elements that can bring people together.
Got back to the conservancy and we all kind of, for our debrief, Karen was leader of the day, we all just kind of wrote nice things about each other in our journals and just kind of recap on our appreciation for each other. So it was a wonderful way to end the trip.
The last day, we were on our way back from Bald Head Island to Southport, and we decided to go surf some waves in our sea kayaks. Half the group decided to sit up, the other half, you know, decided to go at it. Me and Addison are right next to each other, paddling, what, like
12 feet. Like, the waves were
massive,
ridiculous.
Massive waves.
We had to break through the swells before we could surf them, and that was the dangerous part. I think, yeah, I caught the wave, and it pushed me, like, at an angle, and you were here, and then,
Yeah.
I was on top of your boat.
Yeah.
You caught me.
I caught you, yeah.
You caught my boat.
Yeah. And my GoPro was mounted on top of the deck, and his boat knocked it off, but it was still tethered. So I reached down, grabbed it, untethered it, throw it in my cockpit, and put my skirt back on. Later on, I catch a big wave, and I flip, and I'm trying to roll, and I can't get it. And so I pull my skirt, and I can feel my GoPro sink and just between my legs and just into the deep blue abyss that is the ocean. So I'm missing about 3.5 days of awesome footage that is just beyond words, and just, so yeah, that's why there's kind of a big gap in this video, because I lost the camera with 3 days worth of footage on it. So.
Gnarly day though.